Hello students, I welcome you all to the e-learning sessions of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Myself Hardik Shah and I am here to share my knowledge with you all in the subject of automobile engines. Fine. So we are starting today a new chapter about the supercharging, turbocharging and scavenging, and our today's topic on this video, it is basics of supercharging and how superchargers work. Fine. So are you ready? Let's start our video. Before learning about the working of supercharging, let me share a brief history what superchargers are. So since the invention of the internal combustion engine, automotive engineers, speed junkies and race car designers have been searching in many ways to increase the power of the engine. Now one way to increase the power is to make a bigger engines, but there will be one problem. The weight will also increase, the cost will also increase, fine. So it is not possible every time. Another way to increase the power is to make better existing engines. So how can we do that? One trick to increase the efficiency by taking more air into the combustion chamber, and more air means more fuel, right? So more fuel means we can get bigger explosions and it will increase our horsepower. So this can be done by supercharger. Now to achieve it, what we will do? We have to learn what are the superchargers and how we can get that power. So we need to understand its work. Fine. So let's start. I will explain you everything in this video. Fine. So first question is, what is supercharger and what is turbocharger? Fine. So the meaning of supercharging, that you also need to understand. So actually supercharger is a device that pressurizes air intake and high pressure from the atmospheric pressure. Both supercharger and turbochargers do this. So what is the term of turbocharger and what is the term of supercharger, and what is the difference between them? The main difference between supercharger and turbocharger is source of energy. Now actually turbochargers are using mass flow of exhaust gases to drive the turbine and to compress the air, whereas the superchargers are actually run mechanically by belt drive or chain drive from taking the power from the crankshaft. So it will compress air thereafter. So let's see how supercharger works. Now in four stroke engines, first stroke is intake stroke or suction stroke, which is dedicated to the process of air intake. Now in suction stroke, there are three steps in the process. First, the piston moves down from the top. Second one, it is creating a vacuum inside cylinder. And third one, air which is at atmospheric pressure, it is sucked inside the combustion chamber. Now once the air is drawn into the engine, it must be combined with the fuel to form a charge, or you can say a packet of potential energy that can be turned into useful kinetic energy through the chemical reaction, and it is known as the combustion. The spark plug initiates the chemical reaction by igniting the charge, and as the fuel undergoes oxidation, energy is released. This force of explosion concentrated on the cylinder head, and it drives the piston downside, which will create reciprocating motion, and it is transferred to wheel by crankshaft and flywheel. Now we know that getting more fuel into the charge would make more powerful explosions, but you cannot directly increase the fuel inside the engine, because we need to expect the same amount of oxygen which is required in the fuel. Fine. So chemically correct mixture is also required. This means that we need stoichiometric ratio, that is 14:1, to operate the engine perfectly, and it is the simple logic that we need to increase the air also, and that is what supercharger works. Fine. So by taking the inlet air, compressing it outside the engine, thereafter we will inlet it inside the engine and it will create a boost. So with additional air in the boost, more fuel can be added to the charge, the power of engine is increased. Supercharging adds an average of 46% more horsepower and 31% more torque. So it draws air directly from the crankshaft, and most of the driven by the belt drive. So what is happening here? The drive gear will actually rotate our compressor gear, and now the rotor of the compressor, it will take air inside it. It will squeeze the air, it will into the smaller sections, and thereafter it will increase its pressure, and thereafter we will supply it to the inlet manifold. So what is happening inside it? Now there is also one more gear, that is drive gear. So if we increase the size of drive gear, then the compression gear, then we can also increase its RPM. So higher RPM will give us better compression. Okay. So in generally crankshaft is moving at approximate 2000-3000 RPM. In most cases, then 12,000 RPM. So whenever it is moving, we need to increase the RPM of supercharger, and it will be increased to the 50,000 at least. So it will increase 50% more air into the engine, and that is how the air will get compressed. But there is one problem also. When the air is compressed, it gets hotter, which means that it loses its density, and due to the lower density, it cannot expand. So as per the requirement during the explosion, this means that it cannot control or it cannot create the real ignition by the spark plug. So for supercharger, whenever we require higher efficiency, we need to cool down this air. So we are providing one device which is called intercooler. So intercooler is responsible for the cooling process. Now intercooler comes in two basic designs. First is air to air, second is air to water. Both works just like radiator. Okay, so in which the cooler air or water sent through a system of pipes or tubes, as the hot air comes in contact with the cooler pipes, it will cool down. So it reduces the temperature and it will increase the density of the air. Now it can be entered into the combustion chamber because temperature is decreased, and that's how the supercharger works. Let's list out all the parts again. So in supercharger require this of the parts. First is turbine blade, thereafter bell drive, gear drive, intercooler and intake manifold. Fine. So it will accomplish all the process. So now you are familiar with term supercharger. So now let's look the different types of superchargers. Now depending on the construction, there are three types of supercharger. One is root supercharger, twin screw and centrifugal. The main difference among them is how they move air to intake manifold inside the engine. So root and twin screw both are almost same, and they are using lobes. Fine. In a centrifugal supercharger, we are using impeller which draws air inside it. Although these designs provide a very much boost almost similarly, and it depends on the design. Okay. So what is happening in the root supercharger? So let's see one by one what are the superchargers. So first is root supercharger. Fine. In a root supercharger, it is actually very oldest design, and as the mashing lobe spins, air is trapped inside it, and it will trap inside the pockets of the lobes. So it will actually compress the air inside it. Now air will move into the intake manifold, and this is creating a positive pressure in that. So for this reason, root superchargers are really using inside the engines, and it will create a blower effect inside it. Fine. So root superchargers are usually large, and it sit on the top of the engines, and they are popular in the big cars and hot rod cars. Fine. So because of that, seek out hood in the car. However, the at least efficient supercharger for the two reasons. They add more weight to the vehicle, so they move air to the discrete burst instead of the smooth and continuous flow. Second type of the supercharger is actually twin screw supercharger. The third type is centrifugal superchargers. A centrifugal supercharger gets power in impeller as a device which is similar to rotor at very high speeds to quickly draw air into the small compressor housing. Impeller speed can reach up to 50,000 to 60,000 RPM. Now as the air is drawn in the hub of the impeller, centrifugal force causes it to radiate outwards, and the air leaves the impeller at high speed but at low pressure. The diffuser, a set of stationary vents that surround the impeller, converts the high speed low pressure air to the low speed high pressurized air. The air molecules slow down when they hit the vents, and which reduces the velocity of the airflow and increase the pressure. The centrifugal superchargers are the most efficient and most common in all forced induction systems, and they are small, lightweight and very easy to attach in the front of the engine instead of top. So they also make a distinctive whine as the engine gears up, a quality that may turn heads out of the street. So any of these superchargers can be added to the vehicle as per the requirement. Several companies offer kits that come with all of the parts necessary to install the supercharger, as you can do it yourself. Fine. So in the world of funny cars and fuel racers, such customization is an integral part of sports also. Several automobile manufacturers also include superchargers in their production models. So it is in today's session. So in next session, we will discuss about the advantage and disadvantage of superchargers. Fine. So if you have any query, just write in comment section. I will try to solve it as soon as possible. So that's it in today's session. Thank you.